everyone, this is Karaleise. Thank you for watching the video. Today we're talking about business requirements. So we just did a video on what is the business requirement and I uploaded that. And this is the second part in that series to talk about the business requirements and waterfall. Is that the same? Is it the same to say business requirements is waterfall? And I want to jump into that right now, so don't go anywhere. So we're talking about business requirements and waterfall methodology. And a lot of people, when they hear business requirements, they think, oh, this is heavy documentation, this is waterfall, I'm doing agile, I don't need to do that. But the truth is that your business requirements are your business requirements, irrespective of which methodology you're using, right? So you still have to know what the business needs are, and you have to know what your users' needs are, your stakeholders' needs are. So your business requirement really is irrespective of your methodology. And even if you're doing waterfall, you have to know, you know, you have to know your business requirements. The business requirements are the whys and the whats. What are you doing and why? That's your business requirement. And so the waterfall methodology and the agile methodology are just ways in which you document that. If you're working in a waterfall environment, if you're working in a waterfall environment, then you're going to document it with a business requirements document. But if you're working in an agile environment, you're going to document that with user stories and acceptance criteria. It's just two different ways to document the business requirements, which you have to do anyway. So regardless of which environment you're in, you have to do the business requirements, right? So I just want to make that clear. I want to dispel any misconceptions about this. You know, I don't want any confusion. People need to know that you still have to know the business requirements. You have to, and as a matter of fact, sometimes you have to know the whole big picture before you start building small, you know, small little sprints on different functionality. You have to know exactly what you're going to be building and why, right? So don't get confused to think that business requirements is only a waterfall thing, because it is not. All right, well, thank you guys for watching this quick little video about business requirements and waterfall. As I said before, we do have other videos on business requirements. That's a series I'm doing right now, where I just did a video on what is a business requirement. So if you haven't watched that yet, please go watch that. I'm gonna be doing one on business requirements and business rules. What's the difference there? What about business requirements and use case documentation? How is that different? And what are some examples of good business requirements and bad ones? And what should you be looking out for as you go ahead to write your business requirements? So all of that is coming up. If you haven't watched the videos, please go watch them. Please like and subscribe. Click the subscribe button and the bell, okay? And go check out my blog at karaleise.com. Share the video, comment on this video, and I will see you next time in the next video. Take care.